What's up guys, this is Ryan and you're watching the Aquamaniacs. So without any delay, let's get started to the topic. Now this is all about which is the best filter for flowerhorn fish and at what size you should use and can use even the non-best filters if you have nothing else in the moment. So I've got this question asked many times in the WhatsApp group, the old WhatsApp group, and comments on YouTube. I haven't made a video yet, so I thought let's make it right now. And one more thing, that there is no more WhatsApp group of the Aquamaniacs. It has been permanently deleted, so people don't comment saying that add me to the group. I have already mentioned several times there is no more WhatsApp group and no more WhatsApp group going to be made in the future. So now what I have here is a hang on back top filter, you can say hang on back filter. It's a slim filter, WP40H. Okay, you get 50H and 30 also. If you guys need this hang on back filter, it's a really good filter, and I would suggest you guys to use this filter for flowerhorn fries and for big flowerhorns. But when you're using this filter, you can see that sponge over there. You have to remove that sponge. Now I'll tell you why you have to remove that sponge. So you guys have heard of sponge filters. This is not a sponge filter. This is a replica of that. It's made of fiber. It's like plastic fiber. It's a local filter. Every state, every country has their own local filters. You will not get this on Amazon, but it does its job really well. Now you can keep a flowerhorn around 4 to 5 inches using this filter. But once your flowerhorn gets bigger, it will start damaging and pulling the, you know, that silk cotton inside, and even pull that out from its place and move it around, even bite the pipe. So I would not suggest you, if you have a big flower horn, or even if you have a juvenile flower horn, which is 3.5 inches in size, do not use these filters. You can use it when they are this size, as you can see in the video, fry stage. Okay, now what filter you should you use when you have a big size flower horn or flower horns that are bigger than 3.5 inch in size? You should go for a hang on back filter like this, something like this. This is a pretty big filter. This is a 4 feet tank. You can go for top filters. Top filters are on top and the motor goes down. Top filters are really good for flower horn, big flower horns, and hang on back filters are very good. So I would suggest hang on back filter. I'll leave the link of this in the description down below. You can get it from Amazon and even the top filters link. Okay, those are really good. They work really long and they create good water skimming, good water filtration and aeration. Okay, the other thing is, why should you not use sponge filters? Probably you guys have seen those black sponge filters with the pipe sticking out. Do not use those, because you can have some fishes die because of that. Because a lot of fishes, a lot of flowerhorns, not at this size, they will not munch on the sponge. These fries don't munch on the sponge. But once they get to about 3.5 inches and above, I don't know what goes in their head, but it makes them eat it for fun, or when they're hungry, I don't know what they do. But they just munch on it. And when they munch on it, it gets stuck in their intestinal tracts. Okay, it gives them constipation, and I have seen a couple of fishes die because of eating sponge filters. So sponge filters is really not, you know, suggested by me if you have a big flower horn. And many of you have witnessed this, if you kept a sponge filter with a big size flower horn and you probably have removed it. So if you have done that, it's very good. But if your flower horn is 3.5 inches and above, do not go for sponge filters and filters like those. Go for hang on back filters and go for top filters. Okay, or you can even, I don't suggest a normal air stone, you know, a normal air stone or even a rod this long. Never keep the tank, keep the filters above the water, because they have the tendencies to pull a lot of things and move it out of place. So don't use sponge filters or any other filters. I don't want to make this video too long, guys. You're already 4 or 5 minutes into the video. So let's finish this video, and I'll give the list, the link of these two filters in the description link down below. You can order it from Amazon. And also there will be more videos coming up on how to groom flowerhorn fries and how to increase the lifespan of your flowerhorn fry, which food you should feed, till how long you should feed. So So stay tuned, guys. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit the bell icon, subscribe to the channel, and give it a thumbs up. It really motivates me. If I see dislikes too much, I don't feel like making more videos. Okay, I'm not forcing anyone. If you find the video good, you can like it. If not, you can dislike it. And comment your other topics that you want me to make videos on, not only on flowerhorn fishes. It can be any breed of fish, any species of fish. I can help you with that. So thanks a lot for watching, guys. I hope you've gained something from this. Until the next video, a peace.